Hello viewers, I am Rakib. In the previous session, we have learned how to create clipping paths using pen tool, and in this lesson we will see how we can work with this clipping paths. So let's say we have a shape here, we have completed clipping path, and after clipping path we have some issues, like you see it's not correct here, so we have to fix it. To do that, we will select direct selection tool from here, and you can click anywhere of this path. If you click, then you will see all the anchor points are visible, and then you can click any of the anchor points and change its position using the keyboard. You can also drag it to make the curve correct, also correct this one. So in this way you can make this kind of a slight change in your clipping path, and sometimes you got some other issues like this. You can fix it two ways. If you click here and drag it like this, then you can fix it. And another way is you can add anchor points between this two anchor points here, and then you can move that anchor point to correct it. So we will do it here. To add an anchor point, we will go to the pen tool and hold it and select the add anchor point tool from here. And let's add that anchor point in this point, and after adding that point you can drag it like this, and that would also work here. You can also adjust it a little bit. So when it's done, you can click outside. That will deselect the path. And sometimes you may also need to remove some anchor points. Selecting the direct selection tool, if you click here, you can see there is an anchor point in between these two anchor points. If you remove this anchor point, still this two anchor points can hold this path to a straight line. So we don't need this anchor point here, so we can delete it. To delete this anchor point, we will select the delete anchor point from here, and we'll click in this point once, and that will remove that anchor point. And you can see still we have a straight line, which is fine. So in those cases you can also remove your anchor points, and whenever you have some identical shapes and you created clipping path any of them, then you can copy that clipping path and then you can apply it on the other one. To do that, we will select path selection tool from here. We click once, and then you can hold alt from your keyboard. I will hold the shift button as well to move it parallel to the horizontal edges like this, and let's set it. Perfect. So in this way you can copy your clipping path for identical shapes or patterns, and when you have the same type of shapes but in smaller or bigger version, then you can transform this path as well. Make a copy, press Ctrl T from your keyboard, and you can transform it to make it smaller. Let's adjust it using keyboard. Okay, it's fine. So in this way you can also transform the clipping path and make it smaller. So one last example here. You can see we have completed a clipping path on the left side of this shape, but we have not done creating the clipping path on the right, because in here the right side of this shape is the exact same shape of the left side, but it's the reflection of this pattern. So in this case we can again copy this clipping path and make sure you have selected the path selection tool. In time of doing that, press Ctrl T from your keyboard, go to Edit, Transform Path, and then Flip Horizontal. That will flip it and make a reflection of this pattern, and now we can adjust it using the keyboard. So when it's done, we will press enter from our keyboard, and now you can see we have completed the path on the right, but it's not joined yet, so we will do that. To do that, we will select the pen tool and click each of this point like this, and that will join this points, and we have to join the downside as well. We will click this point and this point, that would join this clipping path. So that's it. In this way you can work with this clipping paths and make use of them. Thanks for watching this video. Hope to see you guys in the next lesson.